Leighton Orient Women's Football Club. The O's had hoped to be lighting up the FA Women's National League this season, but due to government restrictions, many of their games have been postponed. After a run of 5 matches unbeaten, the league has been suspended. The girls have been forced to swap the training ground for Zoom sessions, and the fans want to know, what has the experience been like for them? So we found out. Welcome to Lockdown Orient.
Welcome to another episode of Lockdown Orient. I'm Zavi Bird, and I'm joined today by, as ever, by Nicholas Clay. How are you doing, Nick?
Evening, Zavi. Thank you for using my full name there. Appreciate that.
No worries, and we're delighted to be joined this evening by Lauren Herrier and Catherine Long.
Hi, I'm Catherine, and I'm a centre forward for Leighton Orient Women. My day job is I'm an estate agent, and actually I only live about a 6-minute walk to work in Islington.
Hiya, I'm Lauren Herrier, and I'm a centre midfielder at Leighton Orient Women's FC, and I'm also a full-time student at Loughborough University in London studying a sport business master's.
Got to be Michael Owen. Just watching him grow up, I was just absolutely in awe of how many goals he scored. Although he played for Liverpool, just how creative he was, and from being quite a small striker, he's certainly going to go down in history.
I support Arsenal like all of my family, and unsurprisingly, my footballing heroes and heroines are Thierry Henry and Leanne Sanderson.
It's got to be leading my under 15 team, school team out at Wembley as the captain. We played in the national finals at Wembley. It was a half time against, I think it was St Johnstone and some other team, but in front of basically 60,000 people at half time. It was 0-0, so it was a pretty rubbish game. But what an experience for a 15-year-old.
Playing for Charlton in their under 16s team, we went the entire season unbeaten, and we beat the likes of Chelsea and Arsenal to achieve that, so it was massive, and it was a great team as well, so that was an amazing experience to be a part of.
Now, I'm a little bit obsessed with ancient Egypt, studied it at school, and just really, really fascinating. So I'd probably invite Howard Carter, Tutankhamun, and let's go as well for Nefertiti. God, we'd have hours of fun just chatting through what it was like all those years ago.
David Bowie, Taylor Swift and Harry Styles. Thought that could be quite interesting.
It's got to be Disney, it's got to be a Frozen. Let's have a go at Let It Go. I think that I know every single word to it, and those high notes, I still don't reach them, but I'd give it a good bash.
Definitely. Baby by Justin Bieber. Always got that ready to go.
I'm a little bit obsessed with Spider-Man, which is a little bit sad. But yeah, just sort of all the Marvel characters and Spider-Man in particular, I could watch all 3 different Spider-Man over and over again.
I mean, either I'm really cliche and say bend it like Beckham, or Hocus Pocus, which is a sick film and you can watch it anytime. It hasn't got to be Halloween, that's the fact. Just when you go down on Hocus Pocus.
Hi guys.
Hey.
Hey, you're right.
Yeah, we're doing very well. I've got to ask, first and foremost, Orient are going back. How are you guys feeling about that?
Absolutely buzzing. Like, get me back on that pitch.
Yeah, literally can't wait. The whole group chat's been going off all week since we found out. So yeah, we're definitely ready to get back.
We are pumped.
So the first thing we really talk about during Lockdown Orient is it's Lockdown Orient. What have you guys been up to during the lockdown?
I've been working every day. I'm an estate agent. I'm one of those horrible people. So yeah, for me, it's 24 hours a day in the office. So it's kind of business as usual for me. What about you, Lauren?
Well, for me, I'm a student, so I know Catherine. I always wind Catherine up about that because she's working hard in her office. And we are back in lectures now. It's mainly online, but I managed to go to campus today, which is really nice. So just studying, it's deadline season. I know you guys know as well, Nick and Zavi, but yeah.
Is that the first time you've been back in at all?
Yeah, it was really nice. It was great to get over that way. And because I was in East London, I managed to do like some exercise with Kate Kerr as well. So I saw her today. I played football with her, punched her football and then left. So really, really nice to see her.
How did you puncture a football?
Well, I've been working on my shooting, so it's just so powerful now. I actually kicked it. I was like shooting, kicked it against the fence. I weren't aiming for a goal though. I was just hitting it at the fence. Let me clarify that. And yeah, I punctured it. So sorry, Kate, if you're watching, but there's a new one on its way.
Catherine, have you managed to kick a football at all?
I don't even know what shape a football is, no. I don't remember last time I kicked a football. It was probably, the Palace game, Lauren? I'm just trying to think.
Wow.
Is that the last game?
The Actonians game, surely.
Actonians, yeah. I think the Palace
could have been, yeah. Yeah.
You did play, Catherine, I remember.
Yeah. I don't know if I scored. I only remember the ones I scored in.
The Palace was a lockdown before, Catherine.
Oh, was it?
That was the other one, yeah.
You've skipped a few lockdowns, Catherine.
I have missed a few games. That's what I'm really fun.
That's really funny. Everyone else is like, the Actonians was the best day of my life. It's like the best memory of Orient. Catherine's like, did I play?
What happened?
Was I there?
Didn't score, don't matter. Move on. How are you feeling about, the upcoming game then? Are you a bit nervous about going back to play football, or is it more just excitement at the moment?
Like, I know we spoke a lot about the fitness sessions there, but as a team, we've been putting in so much work. So you've had the twice a week fitness sessions. I think a lot of us, when we can get a football at our feet, maybe not Catherine, she's not played since we played Palace, but when we can get a ball at our feet, I know we're all out doing stuff. And we're having like psychology sessions. So yeah, I think I certainly feel ready, and I'm just excited to get back on that pitch now.
It's obviously a huge game against Hounslow, with the possibility in another round's time after that of playing West Ham. Is that driving you guys, the prospect of a big game?
Yeah, let you go first, Catherine.
Go on, Catherine.
Well, I'm a massive West Ham fan, so I don't know how I feel about playing against them. But no, honestly, to play against that level of team as well, that is just going to set us so well for the rest of the season, next season.
What does a psychology session look like?
It's actually super cool. Like, I've never had any sort of sports psychology before. So Serena is leading it. Were you at them, Catherine, as well?
No, I missed that one.
Ah, oh, shocking. Yeah,
no, so goals involved.
No, big lunges.
Ironically, we were goal setting, so we could have done with you there. But yeah. we're looking at talking about team goals, talking about like preparing for the game. It's really good. It's like you do a lot of anonymous answers and feedback, as well as a group discussion. I think it's great, because as a team, I do think we're really close and we share a lot. We support each other, but just to do that extra bit has been really nice as well.
Sounds like there's a lot of ambition with these kind of sessions and looking for the future. And obviously, great opportunity to play West Ham. Do you feel that's the direction the club is headed? They want to progress up the leagues and really make a push for that top level?
I think for us as well, though, like saying that you play for Leighton Orient, like that's a good club. I used to play for Enfield, and people are like, oh, who's Enfield? But Leighton Orient, they've got such a good foundation. It's like everyone knows who they are. So if anything, the men's are in the leagues, it just paves way for us to be like, right, come on, guys, we've got the name, we've got the support, let's smash these leagues. So yeah, I certainly think promotion next 2 years, that's the goal, big time.
Yeah, definitely agree with that. And I think in terms of the support staff we have, so I played National League football up in Leicester, a team called Leicester United, and it's just not even comparable to the team that's been built here around us. So from Tag, from like Serena and the psychology side, Shrey on my course, shout out to Shrey, we love Shrey. Shrey is like doing sponsorship. We're getting like a match analyst team of volunteers from Loughborough Uni. So we're just building this amazing team, which definitely sets us on the right foundation to progress up the leagues. But more than that as well, I think the group of girls we have in the team, I was messaging Sophie this morning, we were just saying like we're always pushing each other to be better, but it's in a really healthy and like supportive way. So I think even if we didn't have all that, I think we'd still be a team that's wanting to be challenging for that title. But just having that around us, it does make it easier as a player. So it's a brilliant club to be at.
I'm very curious to find out how you originally started playing football. What first got you into the game?
Me, probably parents, and as you say, we'll go into it later, but my mum used to manage mine and Lauren's team. So yeah, if anything, it's parents just push you into it. But I think, yeah, the age of like 3 months, I was in the cot like playing with a balloon. So I knew I was always going to kick something. Just what ball that was, didn't quite know yet. But yeah, it's just young age, you just get into it, don't you?
Yeah, definitely similar for me. Like, there's pictures of me playing football with like them little inflatable balls and stuff when it's about half the size of me. So I've always loved playing football. And then when I was probably about 7, 8, or my dad, I wanted to get into a team and there weren't many girls teams around. And I just remember my dad calling up all these different clubs, like, do you have a girls team? And they were like, yeah, but not for that age group. And then we finally found London Girls, which is obviously where me and Catherine played together.
Do you think there'll be fewer girls playing with boys growing up nowadays because it's so, there's more girls playing football? It's just a bigger thing now. Is that going to maybe affect the type of players that they end up being in the future?
I think it's an interesting question. I think definitely now, like you said, there's a lot more girls playing, so maybe there's not that need to always be playing with the boys. But I think I like to think, hopefully, as a society, we're progressing, because I know I had friends who were guys and I'd play football with the boys, but I definitely put up with a lot of chat about the fact I was a girl, I was the only girl there. So, I mean, hopefully now if a girl is playing football with the boys, she's seen as an equal to them. So maybe in some ways barriers are coming down. So yeah, there's more girls playing, but there'll be more kind of an equal playing field for boys and girls to play together. And like Catherine said, I don't know what age it is now when you have to stop playing with the boys, but I think it is so valuable. So hopefully that won't stop.
So girls, it's time for another VAR session. And we've got a couple of goals from you both, and we're gonna let you talk through them as they happen. Now, which goals have we got here, Nick?
Yes, so today I have for you one goal each. So the first goal that we have, Lauren, is your goal from pre-season against Barking Abbey. It's the poacher's instinct that was mentioned in these under 12 match reports. And it's a great drive as well, to be fair. That's you there driving out from the defence as well.
Yeah.
And yeah, as you say, Rhea with the awareness to cut it back, and good finish from you.
Nice goal.
Thank you. I'd say...
Like, oh my God, was that a compliment, Catherine? To someone that wasn't you?
That's one of mine, isn't it?
I think I just keep running. Like, that's the thing. I was like, okay, let me just keep running. And then it paid off in the end. And then I got a goal the week after and I haven't scored since. So I want to get some goals when we get back on the pitch for sure.
And now the next goal that we have is Catherine's goal against Dulwich Hamlet in the FA Cup, the round prior to the Actonians game. So this was the only goal of the game in the 7th minute. So it was the winner. So Catherine, more importantly, do you remember this one?
Oh God, do I? Like it was yesterday. Oh, where am I? Just there, we're floating off screen. Oh, look at that movement. Here we go. In, out, one touch. Bang! Crowd go wild. Look at that.
Yes.
Oh, wait. No, they were silent, weren't they?
Yeah. We didn't have many fans there.
Yeah, I was going to say,
that was like 7 minutes in. That was so early on. And I thought, right, well, this is going to be like a huge scoring game. And we were just so tight on defence that day.
It's good quick free kick. Nice thinking from Mish there. And then it's a lovely cushioned header from Nye as well.
Oh, beautiful assist.
And then what a finish.
Naughty finish, straight in the corner.
Without that goal, we don't get the Actonians moment. That doesn't exist without this goal first.
I don't remember that game.
Yeah, so the last thing we're going to do today, guys, is you might not enjoy this very much, but there's a bit of a competitive angle here. What we've done is Nick and I have gone through both you and some of your teammates' tweets, and we've picked out some of our favourites, and we're going to read them out, and we're going to give you a list of options of who in the squad might have tweeted them, and then you're going to have a chance to guess. Basically, that's the idea. I'm going to go first, and the first one I've got here is the sad realization that Dark Horse doesn't have at Jesse J on it and has Juicy J instead. Jesse and at Katy Perry, hashtag wishlist, hashtag make it happen. who do you think tweeted that? Okay, so your options are Maisie, Catherine, Alison, or Rhea.
I don't know, Catherine.
No. The correct answer is Maisie.
I was thinking Maisie, but she hides that well.
It's a Maisie Cannon tweet.
Damn.
Catherine, you looked fuming that Lauren thought that even might be you.
Katy Perry and horses? Nah.
This next one, Catherine, this is for you. So my first tweet from January 15th, 2010. And this is responding to at Justin Bieber saying that he's going to be at an HMV signing on Monday in London. And the reply is at Justin Bieber. I really wanted to go to the HMV signing, but I have school and a football, in inverted commas, soccer game. Just watched you on GMTV, smiley face, kiss, kiss.
That gives it away a bit, go on.
Your options are Kate Kerr, Hayley Barton, Alison McCann, or Lauren Herrier.
Oh, I hate Lauren. Definitely not. It's got, because the soccer's in there, it's got to be either Alison or Kate. I'm thinking Kate.
You've gone with Kate Kerr. So, Lauren, do you want to reveal the actual answer?
Do you know what? I think it's quite nice that I just translated football to soccer for him.
So. Just in case he was unaware. Yeah.
Clearly a big Bieber fan, Lauren.
I still am. No shame.
This was on October the 24th, 2013 at 8:58 p.m. I want a goat, followed by goat emoji. And your options are Nye, Nick, Catherine, or Barcelona FC official account. Those are your options.
Okay. I mean, goat could be Messi, so I'm thinking maybe Barcelona. I'm going to go Catherine again.
Did you get a goat?
The real question, Catherine, is did you get a goat?
I think I've got greatest of all time title for most hat tricks under 11. But no goat.
Catherine, the next one for you was November the 30th, 2012. And it just says in capital letters, Robbie Williams tickets, ! Yee is the only way I can assume you say that word. And Ollie, smiley face. So was that Kate Bradley, Scarlett Smith, Sky McNally, or was that in fact myself?
Ooh, are you a Robbie Williams fan?
Love him.
The answer will be revealed in about...
Yeah, go on, let's say Sky.
Gone with Sky. So the answer to that was Scarlett Smith.
Oh, I knew it.
Scarlett, nice.
Clearly a massive Robbie fan back in the day, 2012.
And Ollie.
Lauren, your last question is, this was on the 30th of September 2019, so fairly recently. And it's, my toe is completely swollen. Someone please bring me a new one. And your options are Kate Kerr, Egg, Scarlett, or Rhea.
Oh, I feel like it's Kate Kerr or Egg. I've heard a lot about their toes. But who would have tweeted it? That's the question.
Who wants the world to know about their toes?
Kate Kerr.
The answer is Rhea. Rhea Collins.
Damn, okay.
I mean, I'm curious now, like, what kind of things have you heard about their toes?
About Eggs and Kate's toes.
That's team chat. We can't.
Catherine, your next tweet is, if you get an indecisive bae, be prepared for I don't know and I don't mind.
Can I just ask how bae is spelt, please?
B-A-E. Was that Naomi, Nye, Maisie or Mish?
I think that's a Mish saying, I'll be honest. She could just, you know, call anyone bae, but yeah, go on, say Mish.
You're bang on straight away. Yes. That was Michelle Young, yes. Yep, 2015. So Mish, we'll be awaiting the answer if you ever got an indecisive bae.
And unfortunately, that's the end of the episode. Lauren, Catherine, thank you so much for joining us.
Cheers, guys.
And thanks again, Nick, as ever. for being my partner in crime. That's all from us from Knockdown Orient. We'll see you later. Cheers.
Bye-bye.